So possibly one of the most important lessons that we ever need to learn in tattooing, the theory of how to line and the same principles for shading anything else. Today's lesson is the basis of everything that we're going to ever do in the course. You have got to understand these points. So whenever you're doing needle into the skin, these are the things that you're going to have to think about and really, really understand. So let's just quickly go over what those things actually are. Number one, A to B in one motion. Don't worry about these points too much individually. I'm going to go through them point by point, but everything will make sense. But I just want you to be able to get a quick list view of what they all are. Next one, machine angles. Next one, the needle path. Next one, hand and machine speed. How they both relate and work with each other. I'll fully explain it all, don't worry. Last one, stretch. So I'm gonna go through each point one at a time and explain it in fully, so you and if your kid were watching this, they'd understand it as well. But some of these points are more important now as the very beginning. Later on, it's just gonna naturally happen. You will automatically do these things. As I'll explain, the A to B in one motion is the beginner friendly way of doing it. As you're progressing and you get better, you get more experienced, you might not have to do point one, but there's going to be some times, like even now 15 years later, I'll still do this method every now and again. You have got to learn it at the beginning. I'm just going to move these out of the way. Yes, we're back to the little diagrams for all yous that have been on course or the lessons right back from day one. We've got the little machines out. Everybody were messaging saying, look, we prefer that way. It just helped sink in. So we do listen and try and do things that you just prefer. So A to B in one motion. If we're doing a line from point A and we're wanting to do the line to this point, we want our tattoo machine to go in to do the full line in one go and then come out of the skin. So we want to start at point A, go all the way across to point B without having to take the needle out, because we're having to top up with new ink, move as hand position, or any other reason. What we also want to do is practice. So A to B, one motion, and practice. So I'm going to actually add that on just so it makes more sense. And practice. So what I mean by and practice is instead of going in the skin, we're just going to hover over the top and think, can I do that without needing to stop? Again, this is just for the beginning phase. So if I were doing it with my hand lock with a machine, instead of going in the skin, I'd just think, right, that's the line that I want. I can do that look nice and smooth, all right? In one motion, it's practice. Don't worry, we're gonna be relearning all these points on the mats as well later on, but it's just so you get a bit of an understanding. So A to B, one motion and practice. So important. That's that one done. Next up, machine angles. Now, a lot of people, when I first started teaching these lessons, they really didn't understand this. So that's the surface of your skin, the top layer, the first layer. If you're unfamiliar with the skin layout and also which part of the skin that you're wanting the ink to retain in and how it affects, I've got a video just purposely on that. Please go give that a watch. So we've got the first layer of skin, then we've got the second layer, and then underneath that, the layer of skin that we want to avoid is obviously the third layer. Now, machine angles. So we've got a side view of the machine, and we've also got a front view. So we can see the machine is sideways there, it's a side shot, and then one straight on. Let's just learn how machine angles affect where the ink goes. Again, we'll explain this on the mats as well. We can only see the design, obviously, on the surface of the skin. So let's just say we're wanting to make a dot exactly where the stencil is on the skin. There and there. We'll look at the front on version first. So if the machine is upright, the needle penetrates in a straight line and deposits the ink directly underneath the stencil. If we now tilt the machine sideways, so again, this is a front on view. So we're tilting it to the side. I'm tattooing in that direction and it's tilting sideways or the other way, not backwards or forwards. That's what we're going to demonstrate with the side on view. But looking at it from the front, if we now did the dot at this angle, it's going to enter the skin and deposit the ink to the side. Exactly the same if we tilted it the other way, hey presto, it's going to deposit the ink at the correct depth, but slightly to the side. Now, this is the important bit. Just let me move that. The ink does not stay in the surface of the skin, the first layer. It penetrates that and we deposit the ink in the second layer. Once these marks have gone, due to the skin healing, all this is going to renew itself. And from the bird's eye view, so the human eye, looking at the surface of the skin, we're seeing the dots there now, straight up. So although they all entered the skin here, one is left there, one's directly beneath, one's to the side. So essentially, they would be a lot closer together. We're obviously exaggerating this movement just so you understand the principle. But they'd be slightly to the side of each other. Now, we don't want that. We can use it as we could become more advanced later on, actually to his advantage. But that's holding the machine straight, it'd put it directly underneath. Holding it to the side, it'd obviously deposit the ink slightly to that side. Same other way. Them lines disappear and you can only see where it looks at the surface of the skin, because you've got to imagine this line is almost like tracing paper or a sheet of stained glass. And we're looking through the surface of the skin at these bits of ink underneath it. So that's the front on angle. Now let's have a look at a side view. Well, it's the exact same. If we're holding the machine upright, it'll be underneath. Now, usually when we tattoo in, we tilt the machine back a little bit. You'll see all these artists say it needs to be at a specific angle, and they get one of those little tools out and check that it's at the correct angle. I've never seen anybody actually tattoo doing that, thinking, oh shit, that's 43 degrees instead of 45. The angle, it makes no difference. The angle's like that because it's more comfortable to do it. And when you do go in at a slight angle, which had caused that tilting that way, or if, and you would never see this, but if tilting your gawky hand, so we've got the machine, instead of tattooing like this, they would tilt right over. Sometimes for whipping backwards towards yourself, which we cover in some of the lessons, your dot's then going to be there. So again, this is in the second layer of skin. All these disappear and you're just left with what we'd be able to see through that tracing paper or that stained piece of glass. We're looking through this first layer into this second layer. Them dots would now be visible here. So like I said, this is exaggerated just so you understand the principle. Again, we're going to use this to his advantage later on. So for this next little bit, what I'm going to do is just use the side angle, because when we're doing a line, the machine is going to be upright from the front angle. But we do tilt the machine back, don't we? So let me just put that into understanding. So it's straight upright like so, but usually we're tilted back, but it's upright from the front position and we do as line. So we're wanting to do a line from point A to point B. Now, this goes onto the needle path, which is the next point. So we've done as machine angles, how it enters the skin. Now the needle path, we're going from point A to point B. Now we're wanting to go in and deposit the ink in the second layer of skin, all the way across. We don't just fucking throw the boosh. That doesn't happen, right? That would look like this. And because it's an abrupt smashing it in, you'd end up with a blob of ink because it's in this same place for a long duration of time before it sets off. So you'd end up with quite a lot of ink deposited under that bit of skin. This is why sometimes we'll see lines on tattoos and at the beginning, they've got like a bigger blob. That's because of this reason. So now when you're looking online or you see somebody's work and there's blobs at the beginning of the line, this is the reason. This is the thing that causes it. So touch wood, you're learning this before you ever actually even do a tattoo. Same again, leave the skin in that same way. It's potentially got the capability of doing the same at the other side. So what we do want to do is, instead of just stabbing in, stabbing back out at the end, as we enter the skin, we want to set off moving as we get into the correct depth. So now it's a curved line, same as we're coming out. Not too much, just slightly. Later on, when we're doing shading methods and different techniques to create different effects, sometimes we're going to taper out the skin like that, but that'll all make sense when we get to that stage. This is the theory of entering and leaving the skin to doing a straight line. But when you understand this, you learn how to apply it differently to any method. The machine path is this, right? However, let's think back to the angle. Now, if I went straight in, but at that angle, although the needle would be hitting the skin here, it would actually be depositing the ink there. So the line now wouldn't start until there. This is the bit that people find hard to grasp. Just let me explain why. So on the day, the line wants to go from black A to black B. They go in, the needle hits on this point. But we now know, because they've gone in at an angle, the ink is slightly in front. They do the line, they exit the skin. In their eyes, they've got a black line from point A to point B, and it looks solid. It's going to look solid on the day because there's still ink in this bit of skin, and the ink is still visible from this hole as it's leaving the skin. We've got a pool of ink here, but this tunnel that the needle has made has still got bits of ink in. So as we're looking down, that's an eyeball. Wait. So as the human eye is looking down at this, we can still see this dot. Now this skin, over the next few weeks, all heals. That disappears. Now, we can't see this black dot because it's new skin, but we can see this blob of ink that's trapped in the second layer of skin right down here. But we can see it from above and it's here. So, do you know when sometimes you get in lines and they're supposed to meet at a corner like this? They don't. Sometimes they do on the day. As it then heals and the skin renews and this disappears, you're left with little gaps. And we'll see this really, really often. So the way around it is really simple. Whenever we start in a line, we try and start in the upright position. So the ink is deposited in the right place. Simple as that. So hopefully you now know how tilting the machine forwards and backwards affects where the ink goes, and side to side affects where the ink goes. I just want to add to you, on the diagrams where if the ink goes in there and then here, this is a fraction of a millimeter different sometimes. So a lot of people, after listening to this lesson, think, oh God, this is going to cause a problem. And we'll cover this in the later lesson. But if we're doing a square, if I'm doing this line, it's tilted back and it's going in the direction of line. So if I hit the line here, and I'll just do it to the side so you can see, if I go to hit the line there, the ink's actually going to be here, because the machine is like this. So if I'm doing that line, I want to start the line more upright and then I can tilt it and come out of the skin. Now, as I'm going from this point to that point, now look, I'm not in the direction of the line anymore because the line's going that way. So I'm actually pointing that way, which based on this lesson says that I'm going to hit the skin here in line, but the ink is going to be slightly above. So instead of the line being there, It's going to deposit the ink slightly above that line. In theory, this is the theory lesson. Yes, that is true. But also, it's a very, very small amount. So you can either hold it more upright, but because we're doing the entire line like this, you could twist round. So now the you haven't got that problem because it's in the direction. But sometimes comfort, your comfort is going to be more important. So you would just keep your hand the same and you would do that line. Because you're doing the line in one go, it's going to be consistent. This is what I'm going to teach you later on as well. I'll use this color because it's easy to see. So that's your stencil on the skin doing this line. So we get to this stencil and think, right, we need to go from here to here. Well, instead of going in the middle of the stencil, all I do, and it is as simple as this, is just aim at the bottom edge of the stencil because I know the machine is pointing that direction, so the ink will be deposited roughly in middle. So I would carry my line out like that, and the ink, if it does slightly go past that, then it's still within the stencil, so it doesn't matter. Now I'm over explaining this because I really want you to understand it, but at the same time I really don't want you to be confused by it or think that it's an issue. You've just got to understand it. You'll notice as you're tattooing within the first few months exactly what I'm saying, how the angles make a difference. But it's not that big of a difference that you think, I can't tattoo from this angle. Where do I do? And it confuses you. Just understand the theory as we're putting it into practice. As you'll find out, listen, it's loads easier than what it looks as I'm doing the diagrams. So next up is hand speed. This is mega, mega important. Right, we're doing a line from A to B. As we're doing that line, we go in the skin, we carry the line out. Let's just say, and I need to do a few of these lines so they're the same. The time it takes to get from point A to point B on both of these is the same. Let's say it's 2 seconds. So I start 1, 2, and I get to the end. Start the line, 1, 2. Right, so you understand what I'm saying. However, just for easy numbers, this one is 5 volts, that one is 10 volts, double. Again, this is just so you understand the theory. So let's just say 5 volts in 2 seconds, again, just made up numbers for ease, would be 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right, so to do that line, the needle has gone in and out 10 times. Again, we're just doing this for easy numbers. So 10 volts essentially would be double. Now, this is where the hand and machine speed work together. Because if we took 2 seconds to go from point A to point B, it would go in and out 10 times in this instance, because it's at 5 volts. We would double that if we went up by 10 volts to 10 volts, and there'd now be 20. If my hand speed slowed down running at 5 volts, and now this line, the same length as these, but this time I took 4 seconds to complete that line, it's going to give the exact same result as somebody with a faster hand running at twice the speed. We'd still end up with the machine going in 20 times. So these would be identical, even though that one is at 5 volts, okay? But instead of taking 2 seconds, that one takes 4 seconds. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? If we went from point A, did a line, and it took 2 seconds from point A to point B, so in the skin, 1, 2, finished. And we were doing it at 5 volts. For easy numbers, we're saying that 5 volts in 2 seconds punctures the skin 10 times. Now, if we kept the machine running at the same speed, but did that line in 4 seconds, so took twice as long, slowed the hand machine down, 1, 2, 3, 4, going a lot slower, it's the same as doing it at the old hand speed, but doubling the volts. Now I'm repeating this again and again because some people don't just digest things after hearing it once. So for anybody that's thinking, all right, Ben, move on. It's for everybody learns at different speeds. And I need every single one of you people to fully understand this before we get the mats out and start tattooing. So please, if you think, God, you're repeating yourself, I'm doing it because everybody learns different and we've got to do things in a way where everybody can fully grasp this lesson. So hopefully that now makes sense. The hand and the machine speed work together. So this, so let's put a little tick there, stipple shading is where you move your machine at a speed that instead of creating a line, your hand moves quicker that the as the needle is going in and out, the distance between is that far apart that instead of creating a line, it creates dots. So now we know that to achieve this, we can either move the hand really quick, or if you're still wanting to go at normal speed or a lot slower, you can just turn your machine right down. Now I cover this in a lot more detail when we're actually doing the stipple module, but it's just to reinforce how the hand and machine speed work. So again, later on in the course, we can actually use this understanding, this theory, to create a ton of different effects and different shading techniques. So that's how the hand and machine speed work together. Now let's just quickly have a look at stretching. I'm going to show you on here. Now I've got different views on this. That's the surface layer of skin. Second layer, and then, whoa, danger zone. That's the bit that we want to avoid, too deep. Now, as we're entering the skin, the needle, let's just say, is a 5 round shader. So there's 5 needles in a circle. All right. The needles don't just push into the skin and come to the correct depth to deposit the ink without not causing any movement. So as the needle comes in, I'll just change color so it's more visible, the skin will move. Now it moves because of obviously that initial pressure from the needles. As the needle hits the skin, the force causes the skin to move a little bit. Again, we've used this quote, it moves in a curved manner. It's not robotic. It doesn't just move like it's made of steel, all right? But the idea of stretching the skin is to keep that movement as small as possible and as controlled as possible. Because depending on how much the skin moves, whether it's down here or here, would depend on the depth of that ink. Because it'd either be this distance from there to there, or it'd be from there to there, or it'd be that deep. So to get consistent lines or consistent shading, we need to stretch the skin accordingly. Now there's different ways of stretching the skin, and let's be honest, we've heard absolutely all sorts online. That's your tattoo design. Now I've seen loads of people online say you've got to have a 5-point stretch, a 10-point stretch, or we've got to actually involve us feet to stretch the skin and every toe. Listen, the whole idea of stretching the skin is just so the skin doesn't just bounce uncontrollably. It's just to keep the skin nice and tight. That is it. I don't know why people overcomplicate it or bring up all these rules, or you've got to use this many points. So typically people say you need a 3-point stretch. So if that's your tattoo design, you need to be pulling the skin in that direction, and that direction. So it's tight in all ways. And how they usually do that is fingers and thumb of the non-tattooing hand. So if this one is tattoo, they'd be stretching the skin that way. And with the palm of the tattooing hand, they'd be pulling the skin that way and then tattooing in the middle. You can then do the 4-point stretch, which is the exact same, but this time you would, with the palm of that hand, you'd be pulling. So now we create the fourth one. So now we've got the palm pulling that way, the fingers pulling that way, that palm pulling that way, and we're literally stretching everywhere to keep that nice and tight. So that's what we often see. That's how a lot of people like to, especially in small tight areas or smaller designs that's done within that little circle where you can just do that. Perfect. Remember the whole point of stretching the skin to even out that bounce, that movement. Sometimes I just do what a palm stretch where your entire palm rests there, just pulls down in that direction. It depends on the customer's skin. So sometimes my stretching hand would be underneath the design, just pulling down, and then my tattooing hand would be doing the work. That is absolutely fine. It doesn't matter if you're at the top of the design pushing up, pulling to one side and tattooing. You'll see loads of people, and if they're grabbing somebody's arm like so and tattooing at the top, the stretch hand will just be underneath and just grab the entire arm, and you can see on the camera, look, it stretches all the skin because I'm grabbing and tightening the full arm up. Look, you can see it all opening up. So there's no right or wrong. There's loads of different methods of doing it, and some people say you need this many points. I just think your fucking job's worth. Why are we stretching the skin? To keep it nice and taut, to avoid that bounce, and so the needle's going to same depth each time and it's consistent. That's it. Stop coming up with all these things that you've got to do and you need to. No, you don't. As long as the skin is tight, don't matter how you're stretching it, whether you're using your hand, your foot, your fucking cheek, if you want to use your cheek, I don't know. It's ridiculous. As long as the skin is tight and consistent pressure, that is all you need to do. Don't overcomplicate these things. So we've got A to B, one motion practice. It's going from practicing doing the lines. This is mainly just for the beginning. I still do this 15 years later. So it's not a skill that you will never use again. Just good practice at the beginning to do this every single line, which as we're going through the lessons, you're going to get really familiar with. Practice going A to B. Get used to that motion. Can I do it in one go? If not, right, I'm going to have to join the line. Don't worry, I'm going to show you how to join lines together. Machine angles, front on to the side, how the machine angle affects where the ink is deposited. You should know that now. The needle path. We're not just going to straight in to do a line. We're going to go in and gradually taper and come out. Perfect. Hand and machine speed. If we keep as machine at the same volts and go from A to B in so many seconds and then go twice as quick, the needle is going to go in and out half the amount of time because we've gone twice as fast with the hand. So the machine and the hand work side by side together. Last one, stretching the skin. As the needle's hitting in and out of the skin bounces and moves. That can determine how deep the needle is going into the skin. So we need to keep it as taut as possible to avoid that bounce. That's it. Doesn't matter how you're doing it, as long as you do it. And you're gonna find ways. I've got certain ways that I prefer. And then I'll see how my friends tattoo or at a convention, and they're doing totally different ways to me. They're not wrong and I'm right, nor are they right and I'm wrong. It's however you feel comfortable, which at the beginning, you don't know what's gonna feel comfortable for you. I'm gonna go through in a separate lesson the different ways of stretching the skin that I found really useful. And some that I don't really use, but they're just some common ways of doing things. 3-point stretch, 2-point stretch, palm. I've basically just covered most of them. Grabbing the back, especially on the arm, it's a really common place. You would just grab it. But I'll go through loads with you. It's gonna be very difficult for you to practice those stretching movements on a mat whilst we're practicing, all right? But once you've got the experience on the mats and you're comfortable, we're gonna go right back to basics at the end of the full course and then start transitioning all these skills that we've learned into tattooing people. Then you're gonna really get used to stretching the skin and see how important it is, all right? But it's good principle that while we're on the mats, although this, well, this is obviously a whiteboard, but pretending it's a mat, whilst we're doing as tattooing on the mats, we're still gonna be pretending that we would be stretching the skin, just making a conscious understanding, oh, I would be stretching it now. But hopefully those points make sense. If any of it doesn't, re-watch this lesson as many times as you need to until these points sink in.